Let us pray. I thank you, Lord, for all the subscribers you have given for RMCA Bishop channel. Lord, transform every listener into a subscriber. Today, open your heart and speak to your child while listening to this video. Before that, I make this prayer to you. Abba, Father, without you, nothing has any value, and without you, we are nothing. Through you and with you and in you, we exist and possess everything. I trust in your love and mercy for the suffering mankind. If this child of yours is in any kind of financial difficulty this moment, Lord, intervene and give him prosperity. Abba, Father, take control of the family of this humble child. O Jesus, grant this enthusiastic listener your powerful protection from all kinds of evil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise be to Jesus, now and forever. We are meditating on the central theme running through the three encyclicals of Pope Francis, Evangelii Gaudium, Laudato Si, and Fratelli Tutti. Pope's vision is of a world open to brotherhood and sisterhood. In all these, a fundamental part is universal love. Pope Francis affirms that only through it can we make social friendship possible. There is a tendency to reduce oneself into closed groups like my family, my church, my village, my caste, my religion, my social club, my culture, my community, etc. In this context, it has to be reminded, I quote Pope Francis, universal love is openness to the other as opposed to being closed in on oneself. Love is a form of seeking union with others. Love sees the value of others. Love celebrates the worth of the others. Love sees what is best for others. Commenting on this, Cardinal Tagle, the prefect of the Pontifical Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples, Rome, said that it is different from mere romanticism or idealism. I quote, "This is how God loves. This is how God has manifested himself. This is how God, Jesus loves and even died for all. This is how the Spirit blows. God, who is love, is total, full openness." Parable of the Good Samaritan is well referred in the encyclical Fratelli Tutti. The openness of the Samaritan led him to go closer to the stranger left on the roadside and treat him like a brother. It did not stop there. The Samaritan also invited others, the innkeeper, to become an instrument of universal love by taking care of the injured stranger. Here we find a concrete action, desire for the welfare of the other leading to action of love, care, concern, and service. It was not just a lip service. This underlines the importance of responding to a particular situation one encounters in day-to-day life. Otherwise, Cardinal Tagle warned that universal love without genuine response risks remaining a mere concept or a slogan. In this situation, one should not be blind to the actual reality. When one tries to give a proper response, Cardinal affirmed that there is a tension between the specific concrete person and the common dignity of all human beings. Because, I quote, "You cannot enter the dignity of all human beings without entering into concrete specific human beings." There is a risk, certain risk involved, but it is worth taking. When Pope speaks of social friendship, he wants that one should develop and appreciate local cultures. One should not intend to destroy one culture and replace it with another one. Social friendship should be open to universal solidarity. It does not eliminate the uniqueness of any culture at all. Cardinal Tagle went on to note that social friendship can be made concrete in dealing with private property, for example, pointing out that property should never be absolutized at the expense of the common good. What makes this process a difficult one is the greed of man. We can understand the instinct of self-preservation. This instinct is given by God, but it should not fall into the category of greed. Self-preservation is a need, whereas greed is not. So, my dear listeners, today we need to decide on one thing. It is not good to possess more than what is required. Let us look into our own almirahs and see how many pairs of clothes are bundled up in there which we don't use regularly. If a particular thing is not used for a year, then we need to seriously ask a question to ourselves: do I really need it? If no, why not share it with someone who can use it for his survival? There may be many things like that. Hoarding things in our homes is not a good habit. I am not against long vision and planning and getting things ready for a future need. All what I want to make evident is that one anticipation of a future need should not be such. Even in our lifetime, that perceived need can ever happen. Another example, a farmer gets ready with the seeds to sow in the right time. It takes a long process of preparation. Reasonably and arguably, that preparation is for the next season. But on the other hand, if a farmer keeps the seeds for more than his requirement for the coming season, then it may be good to share it with others whose need is for that particular season. There is nothing wrong in keeping things in reserve, but do not need to keep 400 pairs of sandals as wife of the Prime Minister of a nation country once did. This is not an exaggeration. Let us look around and see who is in need of the things that we have extra. Once George Washington asked for a glass of water in the battlefront. When an officer brought it to him, he noticed another soldier lying wounded and dying. Washington immediately offered that glass of water to that wounded soldier. The soldier refused to accept it as it was against the protocol of respecting the senior officer. But the great general told him encouragingly, "My son, your need is greater than mine. I order you to take and drink." That soldier happily, slowly drank the glass of water and quietly departed from this world. My dearest brother, sister, can we also tell someone in need, sharing our resources with them, saying, "Brother, sister, please take this because your need is greater than mine"? If yes, that's how we build His church again. Thanks for listening. If you think it is beneficial to your brother or sister, please be generous to share this video with them. May the Lord, who sees your goodwill, bless you and all your hard work. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please keep me too in your prayers. For additional spiritual enrichment, please listen to video number 6 from RMCA Bishop Channel. With the Lord's of love, your humble servant, Bishop Franco.